Lester William Paulsvoss, also known as Les Paul, was born on June 9, 1915, in a small town right outside of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. At the age of 8, he picked up the harmonica, and after attempting to learn the banjo, he started off on the guitar. When he was about 10 years old, he was given the opportunity to play and sing at Beekman's barbecue stand. Wondering how to amplify his voice for the performance, he took apart his mother's telephone and attached it to a cinder block and a broomstick, then wired it to a radio speaker. When a man in the back told him he could not hear the guitar, young Lester Paulsvoss set out to invent an amplified guitar. All through Lester's youth, he experimented with prototypes for the solid body electric guitar, using railroad ties and blocks of wood and various other objects. One of the first electric guitars Les Paul experimented with in his apartment in Queens, New York was named the Log, merely because it, in fact, resembled a log. It was a 4x4 plank of wood with a fretboard and a guitar pickup that he created at the Epiphone Guitar Factory in Queens, New York. He then added an Epiphone hollow body to the guitar, customized to fit the log. That design fixed two major problems. It increased the guitar's sustain and decreased the guitar's feedback. Though he was not the first person to make a solid body electric guitar, he came forward between 1945 and 1946 and presented his design to the Gibson Corporation. Gibson rejected his design, but later in 1951, after Fender released the Esquire and Telecaster solid body models, Gibson sought out to create their own solid body guitar. They then created a solid body electric guitar using some of Les Paul's ideas and presented the guitar to him to test. Les Paul was so amazed that he signed an endorsement deal with Gibson. So the first Gibson Les Paul was released in 1952. The two original color-on-color patterns were a gold top finish and an ebony finish. Though more colors and designs were later developed, including the later cherry sunburst finish, arctic white, honey burst, vintage burst, and wine red finish.
Everybody's different, and I found that I always just prefer Gibsons, just the way they sound, the way they feel, and I like the way they look better too.
Yeah.
When I was growing up, everyone I knew had a Strat, and I was the only one who had a Les Paul, and I thought that was cool because I thought that Strats were overused.
The Les Paul guitar was a dream to many guitar players at the time, because of the effects that could be added were like nothing available at the time. It also helped that Les Paul himself put out a record showing off all the effects. The sustain and ease of play is a major benefit for many musicians that use the Les Paul. Alongside with that, the Les Paul has a tune-o-matic bridge, which prevents the guitar from going out of tune too easily. Ideal for someone who plays daily concerts and shows. A few of the musicians who use the Gibson Les Paul include Slash, Eric Clapton, Keith Richards, Jimmy Page, and Billy Joe Armstrong. This shows the variety of genres that the Les Paul is used for, like hard rock, blues, classic rock, rock, jazz, country, and punk. The possibilities are endless. All of these musicians have their own signature Les Pauls, with their own signature effects, body, and finishes. The diverse sound qualities of a Les Paul are able to be changed with just a flip of the kill switch. In first position, it has a much heavier tone to it, ideal for metal and hard rock. In third position, the tone is a higher piercing sound, able to punch through rhythm guitars, but still having a harmonic sound to it. Second position is a harmony of both, giving a combined force of piercing and heaviness ideal for rhythm.
Les Paul, there's two humbucker pickups, and the term humbucker simply refers to the fact that on the underneath this metal plate, there are magnets, and those magnets are wrapped. This is going to be a higher, brighter pitch sounding tone because it's close to the bridge. Just like when you pick here, it gets warmer the closer you go this way. Back here it gets thinner. So the pickup is picking up a string sound that's a little thinner sounding than this one is. So this pickup then is the neck pickup. It's going to be a bit darker and a little more bass sounding in character. So this is a truss rod cover, and that rod goes all the way through to the end of the instrument. this, the back side of it is how you get, that's how you get to the electronics of these knobs. So you just take that plate off, and you can get to the wiring where you can resolder things if you lose a connection or whatnot. And this one would be the plate that covers the wiring for the toggle switch.
Later in his career, he released a new album in 2005 entitled Les Paul and Friends, American Made and World Played. He also played in Broadway in the Iridian Jazz Club and was in the movie Les Paul Chasing Sound, a documentary on his life. Unfortunately, Les Paul passed away on August 12, 2009 due to complication from pneumonia in White Plains, New York. Upon learning of his death, many artists and musicians paid tribute by publicly expressing their sorrow. After learning of Paul's death, former Guns N' Roses and Velvet Revolver guitarist Slash called him vibrant and full of positive energy. U2 guitarist The Edge also stated, "His legacy as a musician and inventor will live on, and his influence on rock and roll will never be forgotten."
With more than 15 models and variations, the Les Paul has proved its versatility, ease of play, sound quality, and looks throughout time and through the many guitarists that choose the Les Paul. Even today, the Gibson Corporation is perfecting and improving the Les Paul, such as the release of the first robot guitar in December 2007. Now, along with many features that helped make the Les Paul popular in the first place, the robot guitar is able to tune to many tunings with the new master control knob recently installed. Unlike similar systems, the robot guitar does not need heavy modification to the guitar. There's truly no comparison to the innovative Les Paul, and there most likely will never be.